Here's a question worth asking. Why haven't Valve released Proton on the Mac? I mean, you can get Wine for the Mac. You can even compile Proton from source on the Mac. But Steam Play is not available, since Proton's not integrated with the Mac Steam client. Why is that? Hi, I'm Gardiner, the Linux gamer, and here's my take. The most obvious reason that Valve have opted out of supporting the Mac is that, well, another platform means additional cost, and who can blame them? While it's true that a few years ago they said they didn't want to support Wine through the Linux client because it would cost too much, it had to happen. It was an inevitability. And yes, it's definitely costing them a pretty penny to develop and support Proton. So I can see how some might think that the Macintosh might eventually get the Steam Play treatment. But I wouldn't be so sure about that. Today, Apple products, at least the Macintosh line, don't use the particularly exotic hardware that they were infamous for historically. They're running an x86 architecture, for the time being, using modern graphics chipsets, and more or less doing things the way other PC manufacturers do. But the problem isn't really in the hardware. The problem is in the software. Vulkan is not supported on the Mac. Instead, they use their own proprietary graphics API called Metal. Because when I think Apple, I think
Metal!
They've also depreciated OpenGL, which was never fully supported on the Mac to begin with. These two facts alone would be enough to call a true port of Proton a virtual impossibility. But then you need to factor in the drivers. Once upon a time, the graphics driver support on Linux was widely and rightfully considered to be the worst of the major three desktop operating systems. But that's no longer the case. Due in no small part to Valve's leadership on this front, hardware vendors have been publishing their graphics drivers for Linux at a much greater pace and for a wider variety of hardware, too. Compare this to the Mac, where there's only a select number of graphics chipsets available, and the driver support simply isn't up to snuff. Couple all that with thermal throttling, laptop parts being used in their desktop line, all this leads me to the final reason that the Macintosh will never see this new version of Steam Play. Valve's endgame here is simple. They're trying to divorce the Windows games they sell from Windows. But why? Because as we speak, Microsoft are actively pursuing an Apple-inspired walled garden approach to Windows 10. Just look at the evidence. Forced updates that break compatibility with old apps, the depreciation of legacy software, which, hey, guess what? That means Steam, and a monolithic storefront that Microsoft is fully intent on pushing as the only place to get your software from. You see, I'm not Chicken Little over here. There have already been two versions of Windows 10 released that only allow for software through Microsoft's official channels. It's no stretch of the imagination to say that it's merely a matter of time before the Windows Store is the only way to get software on Windows 10. So Valve knows this. That's why Proton exists. They need to decouple the games they sell from the platforms that are actively hostile towards them and their business. So why won't the Mac ever see the Steam Play Proton combo? It's not just the cost or the shoddy graphics support. Apple and Microsoft are two sides of the same coin. Closed, proprietary systems that are hostile towards Valve and their business. And that's why Proton on the Mac will never happen. But what do you think? Are you holding out hope that the Mac will eventually get Proton? Leave me a comment and let me know, or hit me up on Twitter at TheLinuxGamer. If you believe in the work that I do, you can support this show with a monthly contribution over on Patreon, or you can pick up a t-shirt, there's a link down below. But whatever you do, whether it's hitting that like button or sharing this video with your friends, don't forget to subscribe to see more from me, The Linux Gamer. And as always, thanks for watching.